Well, you know, it's not even about putting people in their place. It's just really about the truth. They need to hear the truth. That's all.
Playing time. A lot, you know, a few of the parents always, they talk about playing time. And, you know, playing time, again, is earned in practice. It's just, you know, we know being former athletes, you earn playing time in practice. And you earn playing time in not making the same mistake over and over and over again.
Step your game up. You stop freaking crying. Step your game up. Because ball is about playing defense. They developing the game. You all stop second guessing yourself and play ball. And take
I feel that parents have their kids involved with sports, basketball in particular, with us, because they want the next LeBron James. They want the next Steph Curry. And they believe that their kid, if he starts early, that he will be that. They believe that. And it is such, they're so disillusioned. And that is what grinds my gears about these parents.
Your son when he go out there.
Steal balls. Take them out defense. Or you're going to get a whooping. Make mess.
Or you going to get a whooping?
That's what she said, Lord.
They really believe that, you know, and they don't understand that to make it to the NBA, all the stars have to line up. They really do. I mean, it's so many things that can happen that can, you know, that can throw it off course. I'll use Anthony Davis as an example. No, and Anthony will tell you this. His parents will as well. Anthony was a good guard. He really was. He was a good player with First Step on up to high school. He was a good player. He had guard skills. He could shoot. He could handle the ball well. But by the time he was going into his junior year, he shot up 7 inches. So that took him from being just a good guard in the city of Chicago to the number one player in the country. You know, so that was the blessing that God touched him on the head with. He's not going to touch everybody on the head like that.
Kids ever do anything wrong?
Yes.
Okay.
And we
okay.
Let them know.
Okay. I just want. Yeah, okay. Okay.
But in the moment, no, they're always right. Okay.
Them boys can't out here at bus now.
For a little bit of ourselves for a few hours, and we were gonna come back and take the kids again. And when that was brought to the parents, they really went haywire. You know, well, you guys said you were gonna watch the kids and da da da. Okay, we understand that, but the bottom line is these are you all's kids.
Tell me about your boy playing out there today.
Oh, we put on his shoulder and don't choke up on the big stage. Okay. On the big stage, so they gotta come on with it.
Okay.
First step in the house.
How do you feel? How has he liked the trip so far?
Oh, he loving it. I only seen him a couple of times. He ain't called, so that means he having fun.
How have you liked the trip?
Oh, man. I ain't had a bomb.
Okay.
It ain't over. It ain't over, baby.
It ain't over yet.
I honestly, like, without them, like I said before, basketball probably wouldn't be as significant as it would be for me right now. You know, definitely taught me a lot about the game, you know, and, you know, me being this little skinny kid from Chicago who, run around with like a chicken with his head cut off, you know. It definitely put stability into my game.
Anthony Davis, you went to my school.
First, I probably wouldn't be where I am today.
It's kind of a twilight zone. I can remember when I was playing for First Step or when I was playing in high school and college, and my coach would get on me, and I would be like, why are they getting on me so hard? But as I got older, I understood they're demanding 100% out of me. And from them doing that, I gave 120%. So even though the group of kids that I have, they're only in fourth grade, but as you know, because you're at the games, I demand 100% out of them. And you know, at first they were kind of like, who is this kind of pretty girl yelling at me like this? I don't really understand. But once I had a talk with them and told them, I'm doing it because I want you to succeed, and I see myself in you because I once walked in your shoes. And I'm going to be this way. I'm going to be aggressive. I'm going to be in your face. But now they understand. And now we're winning championships.